In this presentation, we will review the CAFIS Fueling ULC tank farm facility. The Dorval Airport Tank Farm stores, receives, and distributes Jet A1 fuel for the Montreal International Airport. Aviation Jet A1 fuel is received and stored in 5 above-ground storage tanks. Storage tanks T1, T2, and T3 are 51 feet high and have a diameter of 60 feet. The product capacity of each storage tank is approximately 3.8 million liters. Storage tanks T4 and T5 are 41.5 feet high and have a diameter of 45 feet. The product capacity of each storage tank is approximately 1.7 million liters. All 5 storage tanks have an approximate total capacity of 14.8 million liters, or 3.91 million U.S. gallons. Each storage tank is made of epoxy-lined steel and equipped with a high-level alarm, known as NRAF, and a floating roof system, which is fitted with movable legs. These legs can be extended and locked in order to facilitate yearly tank inspections, cleaning, and maintenance. All 5 storage tanks are equipped with a floating suction unit, which retrieves fuel from the top of the storage tanks. This maintains the highest quality of fuel by allowing any surfactants or free water in the fuel to settle to the bottom of the tank, where it can be discarded through the daily sumping process. Fuel received by dedicated tanker truck deliveries is distributed to pre-selected storage tanks from the tank farms off Loading Island, and by way of pipeline from the Montreal East refineries through an underground pipeline operated by Trans-Northern Pipelines. The fuel is filtered, sampled, and metered at the Trans-Northern Pipelines facilities adjacent to the CAFIS Fueling ULC tank farm. The fuel being received is pumped into a common manifold where it is diverted into a pre-selected storage tank through a 16-inch altitude valve, entering through the lower portion of the tank. Should the fuel being received exceed tank capacity levels, the high-level alarm system will shut off the valve tendering fuel and alert the tank farm operator. For added safety, each storage tank is backed by a roof shut-off float system. The fuel received is analyzed and tested by an independent laboratory who will advise the tank farm operator that the fuel being received meets Canadian and international standards for into-plane Jet A1 fuel before it is pumped to the Montreal International Airport and into aircrafts. The dike drainage valve is also interlocked when receiving a tender, maintaining the drainage valve in the closed position for the duration of the tender. Any fuel leaks or spills will be contained in the storage tank's dike. Storage tanks 1 through 5 are each connected to a 24-inch Jet A1 suction header, which is connected to the main transfer line pumps and filter separators, known as P6, P7, P10, and P11. Each filter vessel contains 26 coalescer-type fuel filters and water strippers. With a pumping rate of 18,000 liters per minute, the fuel is pumped through underground pipelines, leading to the airport ramp where it can be accessed by aircraft fueling vehicles. A 24-inch double block and bleed valve at the southeast end of the tank farm is used to isolate the tank line for maintenance. All functions of the tank farm can be controlled from the computer interface unit, otherwise known as the OIU. The OIU is an industrial microcomputer used to communicate information to and from the Programmable Logic Controller, or PLC. The OIU contains several different displays representing different aspects of the tank farm operations, such as jet fuel loading and unloading, jet fuel transfer pumps, valve controls, tender and truck deliveries, tank fuel levels and meters. Some services that are accessible from OIU include the oil water separators or the OWS, fire protection, and electrical schematics. The OIU also allows the TFO to obtain reports such as pump counters and filter differential information. The tank farm operator can monitor the performance of the tank farm functions from the OIU. The PLC constantly evaluates the status of the tank farm's varied systems and will sound alarms if problems are detected. A description of the type of alarm is displayed on the OIU screen until acknowledged by the tank farm operator. Should a power failure occur, the tank farm is equipped with a 900 kilowatt diesel generator which has an abundant capacity to replace the Hydro-Québec electrical supply. The system is automated and will sense a loss of power, which in turn will cause the generator to start after a short period of time. The OIU and PLC systems and functions are protected by the uninterrupted power source unit from temporary power loss in the time between the occurrence of a power failure and the startup of the tank farm generator. The UPS unit allows power to be drawn from its internal batteries, providing uninterrupted power to essential systems. The above-ground storage tanks are surrounded by a dike made of impervious clay, covered with 5/8-inch stone. The moat capacity is that of the volume of the largest storage tank, plus 10%, which meets the environmental requirements of 1.10% of the largest storage tank. A normally closed, manually operated post valve leading to the OWS controls any fluid discharged from the dike area. When the dike valve is in the open position, an interlock feature on this valve will prevent the PLC from allowing reception of fuel into any storage tanks. The transfer pump line is also protected by a concrete enclosure with 20-inch retention walls. Any discharge of fluid is directed through underground conduits to the OWS. The oil water separator, otherwise known as the OWS, is located underground at the north end of the tank farm and is connected to all dike drainage valves, piping, and drain catch basins, except for the sanitary drainage. The oil water separator has a capacity of 58,760 liters. This is a continuous flow separator, which is controlled by a normally opened inlet and outlet valve leading to the city's drainage system. The OWS is equipped with a monitoring system, which provides high-level oil alarms connected to a panel in the tank farm control room. Should the monitoring system recognize high oil levels, the PLC will automatically shut off the OWS outlet. Most fueling gates at the Montreal International Airport are equipped with an emergency shutoff box, which, when activated, will automatically send a signal to the tank farm's OIU panel, shutting off all the transfer pumps. Three of these shutoff boxes are located at the tank farm's pump line, delivery island, and on the control panel itself. All five storage tanks are protected from fire through a foam suppression system, which is located in the tank farm control building. Should the sensors detect a fire, an alarm will sound alerting the tank farm operator and the fire department. Using the foam suppression system, water and foam can be directed to individual storage tanks. The tank farm is equipped with a cathodic protection system, which includes both impressed current and sacrificial anode systems. This system prevents the deterioration of the metal components of the tank farm and its underground piping. The system is inspected monthly, and rectifier boxes are read and recorded. Duties expected of the tank farm operator are to ensure a safe, secure, and professional work environment. There are two access points to the facility, being the entry gate and the exit gate. Both of these gates are remotely opened and closed by the tank farm operator from the control room. Visitors are not able to access the facility without the permission of a tank farm employee. All tank farm employees are responsible for challenging unfamiliar people at the site and are responsible for not allowing access to unauthorized personnel. When visitors are on site, it is important that they are escorted at all times. All gates and access doors must remain closed and locked when applicable. All fences and gates must be secured when the tank farm is unattended. This concludes our overview of the CAFIS Fueling ULC Tank Farm Facility.